Good morning, everyone. This is your English class, and today we are going to study our next chapter, that is verbs expressing the past. So let's get started. Chapter 3. Simple past tense. So basically, dear students, in this tense, we are going to understand about simple past tense and past continuous tense. Okay. So firstly, let's understand about simple past tense, and we can say it past indefinite tense. So whatever you want to say, like simple past and past indefinite tense, we can say. First of all, let's understand the uses of this tense. First point, to express the actions which were finished before the time of speaking. So when we talk about those actions which were finished before the time of speaking, means which were finished in the past, for those actions we should use simple past tense. Some examples are here. Like if I say that we saw a thrilled film last night. So last night is past time. I'm talking about the past. I saw a film. So I'm talking about that. So for this, I have used simple past tense. Right. Next, we went to a hotel for dinner. I'm talking about the past, not present. In past, I went for dinner in a hotel. So that's why I have used here simple past tense. So simply we can understand jo kaam humne past mein kiye, for those actions we should use simple past tense, right? I helped him that day. I'm not talking about present, I'm talking about past. I did this work of helping, right? That's why I have used here simple past tense. Next point. Secondly, we use this tense to express the past habit. So dear students, whenever we express the habit and that is related to past, so we can use this tense. Like my grandfather liked a cup of hot milk at bedtime. So in this sentence, I'm expressing the habit of my grandfather. So in the past, he had the habit of having a cup of hot milk at a bedtime. So I have used here simple past tense. Remember this, whenever we have to explain, we have to express the past habit, not present. So we should use simple past tense. Next, my younger brother fought me a lot. I'm talking about the past. At present, my younger brother does not fight with me, but in past he used to fight. He fought me a lot. My neighbor smoked too much. So I'm talking about my neighbor person. So he had the habit of smoking. So I'm talking about him. So that's why I have used here simple past tense, right? So basically, dear students, we have understood that for two main purposes, we use simple past tense whenever we have to express about something which happened in the past. So we should use simple past. And when we express the past habit, for those actions also we should use simple past tense, right? Now let's understand the formation of a simple past tense, right? So if our sentence is simple or positive, so first of all we need to use subject, then main verb, then object. Point to be noted that in simple sentence or in positive sentence, there is no helping verb. Means subject we have to use, main verb we have to use, object we have to use. But see the negative sentence formation. In the negative sentence formation, we have to use helping verb and main verb. Both the verbs we have to use. So first of all, subject, then helping verb, then not the main verb, then object will come. If our sentence is interrogative, so we know that in interrogative sentence, first of all, we should use helping verb before the subject, then main verb, then object. If sentence is negative interrogative, then helping verb, subject, noun, main verb, object. Right? If our sentence is WH interrogative sentence, so first of all, WH word will be mentioned there, then helping verb, then subject, then main verb, then object. Okay? Again, I tell you, remember this point in simple sentence or in positive sentence of simple past tense, we should not use helping verb. Okay? But in negative interrogative or negative interrogative sentences, we should use helping verb along with the main verb. Right? And these things I have told you, subject like a noun or pronoun, helping verb, did, main verb, first form and second form and first form, base form, right? Object, nouns and pronouns. Okay, so suppose I say that Virat did not play cricket. So Virat is subject, that's a noun. Did, that's a helping verb, not, that's a adverb. Due to negativity we have used here. So play, that's a main verb, root form, then cricket, object, that's a noun or pronoun. Okay, Virat subject, did helping verb, play main verb, cricket, object. Did you help him, did helping verb, use subject, helping verb, so you help main verb and him object, right? This one, now we have to understand, I have told you two verbs are used in this tense, second form and first form. We have two options. So according to what we should use first form or second form, this thing we have to understand, right? So second form will be used in positive sentence. Whenever your sentence is positive, you should use only second form if you are talking about the past, okay? But in negative sentence or in interrogative sentence or in negative interrogative sentence, you have to use first form, root form, okay? Secondly, helping verb is did, okay? So we don't have any option. So remember this, wherever we have to use helping verb, so only one option we have. So always we will use did helping verb if we are talking about the simple past tense. Second, like special note, I have written here, with did use the root form, first form of the main verb. So remember this, whenever your sentence is positive, so you will not use helping verb there. So there you have to use second form. But if you make negative sentence or interrogative sentence or negative interrogative sentence, there you will use helping verb did. And with the helping verb did, you need to remember that you should use only root form. So in English, you should always remember this rule. Whenever you write do, does or did, do, does and did, with do, does and did, always you have to write root form, base form. Okay, so let's do some practice on the behalf of this understanding. If you wish, again I tell you each and everything so that you will not get any confusion. Again I tell you this, all the things. So remember this, whenever we talk about past, something happened in the past, so we should write the simple past tense. And whenever we have to express the past habit, there also we should use simple past tense. Information, if your sentence is positive or simple, use subject, main verb, object. Don't use helping verb in simple sentence of simple present tense. But if your sentence is negative, interrogative or negative interrogative, so there you have to use helping verb also. Helping verb is only one, that is did, so no option is there. So you have to use did helping verb. There is a need of using the helping verb there. Okay, second point, I have told you two verbs we have to use in this, second form and first form. In positive sentence, you will use two, means second form. But in negative or interrogative sentence, you will use first form. This point you can also remember, this point, like with did, you have to always use root form, right? Because did we use in negative sentence, in interrogative and in negative interrogative. In the same way, in the negative interrogative and negative interrogative sentences, we use the first form, means root form. Okay, let's do some practice on the behalf of this. Find the error in the given sentences. So you have to read the sentences and you have to raise your hand, okay, if you find error. sorry, first sentence is that I did not saw him yesterday. I did not saw him yesterday. So please raise your hand if you know the answer. What's the mistake in this sentence? Please let me do some setting here from my end. Please wait a while. I need to extend the size of this box. Please wait. Yes, now I can see. So first of all, Payal will come. Payal, please tell me what's the mistake in this.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning. Payal, can you tell me what's the mistake in this sentence?
Yes, sir. आपने कहा था कि जब did not आ जाए तो verb की first form आएगी ना कि second. इसलिए sentence ये सही बनेगा. I did not see him yesterday.
Yes, very good. So we should always remember with the did we need to use always root form. So did is there. So did is helping verb here. So with the helping verb we should use root form. So see word will come. While you have given the absolutely right answer with the good explanation. Very good. Okay, come on the second sentence. But my brother see him. But my brother see him. Remember this. In all the sentences, I will use simple past tense. So according to simple past tense, you need to find the error. Okay. Sanchi Bhatia, please come forward. Sanchi, you please tell me. What's the mistake in second sentence? Sanchi.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning.
Sir, in this sentence, we will use, but my brother saw him.
Yes, but my brother saw him. Because we are talking about past and we are using here positive sentence, means affirmative sentence. That's why we need to use second form. Very good. Right answer. My brother, but my brother saw him. Good. Right answer. Next is that what you did there. What you did there. So can you tell me what's the mistake in third sentence? What you did there. Who will let me know? Sneha, you please tell me. Sneha.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, यहाँ पे what you did.
Sneha, your answer is not right. Please try to give the right answer. You can again try. Okay, I tell you the answer. Actually, I have told you whenever we make any interrogative sentence, so always we use helping verb before the subject. Okay. So helping verb will come here and main verb also we need to put here. So we need to say this sentence. This is an interrogative sentence. You can see in the last of the sentence, interrogation mark is there. So you need to write this sentence. What did you do there? What did you do there? Okay. Next is that. Who did go there? Who did go there? What's the mistake in this sentence? Mihika, please tell me. Mihika, Meghan.
Good morning, sir.
Hey, good morning.
Sir, Meghan.
Meghan, okay. Meghan, please tell me. What's the mistake in this
sentence? Who did goes there?
Who did goes there? Goes, I did not teach you in this tense. Mika, another try, please. Meghan, sorry. Meghan, your answer is not right. You can try again. If you want,
go there?
Who?
Who did go to there?
No. Okay, actually, I tell you, it's quite a tricky sentence, so I tell you. So basically, dear students, I have told you whenever we make any interrogative sentence, right? So we should use helping verb before the subject. But see this sentence, who did go there? Actually, I'm talking about the subject. Means I want to know about the subject. There is no subject in this sentence. So in that case, we should use the formation of simple sentence. Means firstly subject, then second form, then rest of things will come. Subject is not there, so who will come first? So we need to say this sentence, who went there, right? In who, we should remember that there is a no subject, so we should use who sentence with the formation of simple sentence, in positive sentence. Subject, second form, object, or rest of things. Subject is not there, so who is subject here, right? Second sentence, next sentence means, I did not help him. I did not help him. What's the mistake in this sentence? Disha, you please tell me. Disha. Dear friends, if you do not know the answer, please don't raise your hand. Okay. Mannat, you please tell me.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning.
Sir, I did not help him.
Means, what's the mistake here?
Sir, helped.
Yes, yes, right. Very good. Means, instead of helped, help word will come. Means, I have told you, whenever you use did helping verb, so with the did, we need to use root form, base form. Yes, Manat, very good. You have given the right answer. Come on, the next sentence. Whom did you met? Whom did you met? Tum kisse mile the? Whom did you met? So what's the mistake in this sentence? Chandan Singh. Who is Chandan Singh? Please come forward. But please let me know what's the mistake here. Chandan Singh, can you tell the answer? Very good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir. Sir, meet.
Meet, yes. Instead of met, meet word will come because I have told you whenever we use did helping verb, so with the did, always we need to use root form. Very good. You have given the right answer. Next, I did met Sahil. I did met Sahil. So what's the mistake in this sentence? Hemant Rana. Hemant, please you tell me. I did met Sahil.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning, Hemant. Hemant, please you tell me.
I did meet Sahil.
I did meet Sahil. No, beta. We need to use positive sentence. So how can we use did? I met Sahil, we need to say. Okay. Did is a helping verb and we should use it in negative sentence, in interrogative and in negative interrogative sentence. Okay. Dear students, again, I tell you, if your answer is wrong, so don't feel bad. We are not perfect. We are learners. We are trying to learn. Okay. So if your answer is wrong, so don't feel bad. You should try once again. Okay. Don't stop trying. Next. State the interrogative sentences with the help of the given clues. So some clues are given here. So you need to use those clues and you have to say some sentences. Those sentences should be interrogative. Okay. Let's start. First is whose he steal. Whose he steal? So we can say this sentence, whose pen did he steal? First, I'm telling you. So in this way, you have to make an interrogative sentence. Like clues we have, whose, he, and steal words. These words we have. So we can say that whose pen did he steal? Okay. First, I have told you. Second, third, and all the sentences you have to do by yourself. Means you have to give the answer here. Tell me about second. How often they go? How often? Often means how often means kitni baar? How often they go? Make one sentence with the help of given clues. How often they go? These words are here. Make any interrogative sentence with the help of these words. Mansi, you please tell me.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning, Mansi.
Sir, how often did they go to market?
How often did they go to market? Yes, very good. Nice answer. In same way, come on the next sentence. How Ravi achieve? How Ravi achieve? So what can be your answer regarding these words? Please raise your hand. Ishmeet Singh, please come. Ishmeet, you please tell me what can be the answer of this.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning.
How did Ravi achieve the goal?
Yes, how did Ravi achieve the goal? Yes, very good, right answer.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, very good. Welcome. Next, whom he abused? Whom he abused? Abuse means gali dena. Whom he abused? Make any interrogative sentence. Suraj, you please tell me.
Sir, whom did he abuse?
Very simple. Whom did he abuse? Very good. Next sentence. When your friends go. When your friends go. Who will let me know? Shivani, you please tell me.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning. Shivani, please tell me.
When did your friends go to the market?
When did your friends go to the market? Yes, very good. Right answer. Next. Past continuous tense. So I think there is no doubt regarding this tense. So we can move on the past continuous tense. So uses, firstly, you will understand the uses of past continuous tense. Now please down your hands. To express an action in progress at some moment before the time of speaking. So dear students, basically we can understand. We need to use past continuous tense when we talk about the past. An action was going on in the past, not in the present. So for those actions, we should use past continuous tense, right? Some examples are here. Like if I say it was raining hard at 5 o'clock last evening. So I am talking about past because last evening, these words I have mentioned here. Okay. An action was going on. What was the action? Action of raining means raining was going on. Okay. So when any action was going on in the past, for those actions, we should use past continuous tense, right? Next, I was getting ready to go to the concert. So I'm talking about the past and I'm talking about which action means an action which was going on in the past. I was getting ready. Okay. So action was incomplete. You were sleeping. I'm telling you a state. Action of sleeping was going on that time. I'm talking about the past. So we should use simple past tense. Right. So I think we have understood this tense very well. So whenever we talk about the past, any action was going on in the past that was not completed, that was incomplete. So we should use past continuous tense for those actions. Okay. Next point, formations. We have to understand here formations. So formation simple past tense formation is that if sentence is simple or positive, first of all use subject, then helping verb, then main, then object. Remember this, dear student. In simple past and in simple present, two tenses are here. In the simple past and in the simple present, in the simple sentence of these tenses, we do not use helping verb. सिंपल पास्ट के और सिंपल प्रेजेंट के सिंपल सेंटेंस में हम हेल्पिंग वर्ब नहीं यूज करते एंड इन द रेस्ट ऑफ टेंसेस वी हैव टू यूज हेल्पिंग वर्ब इन द सिंपल सेंटेंस सिंपल मींस पॉजिटिव सेंटेंस और वी कैन से अफर्मेटिव सेंटेंस राइट नेगेटिव वी नीड टू यूज नॉट विद द हेल्पिंग वर्ब मींस सब्जेक्ट हेल्पिंग वर्ब नॉट मेन वर्ब ऑब्जेक्ट इंट्रोगेटिव सेंटेंस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हेल्पिंग वर्ब देन सब्जेक्ट देन मेन वर्ब देन ऑब्जेक्ट Negative interrogative, first of all, helping verb, subject, not main verb, object. If our sentence is WH interrogative, so WH word will come, then helping verb, then subject, then main verb, then object, right? Subject, nouns and pronouns, same thing. Helping verb, yes. Dear students, helping verbs and main verbs of all the tenses, you have to learn that, okay? You should learn that. I'm talking about this tense and in this tense, I need to use this helping verb and this main verb. Right, so helping verbs and main verbs we need to learn. Suraj Thakur, don't raise your hand in the last. You can raise your hand. Main verb fourth form, base form. Okay, means like a fourth form means base form plus ing. We can say it ing form or we can say it fourth form. About the forms, I have told you. Then object, nouns or pronouns. Like. Rahul was watching TV. Rahul subject, was helping verb, watching main verb, fourth form, TV object. Note, main verb, fourth form, base form. So there is an option. So with every type of subject, we need to use fourth form, base form plus ing. Helping verb, two options are here, was and were. Whenever, dear students, you have two options in helping verbs or in main verbs, then according to subject, you have to use the helping verb or main verb. Okay. So if our subject is third person singular, like he, she, it, or name, and first person singular also. So this is a rule in English with the first person singular and with the third person singular means I, he, she, it, or any name. We should use was, right? Because was is considered singular. And with the rest of subjects means we, you, they names like first person plural, second person singular and plural, third person plural, we should use were. Okay. Now regarding this, find some error. First sentence is that our team was playing well in the tournament. So who will let me know what's the mistake in this sentence? Let me see. Please wait. Yeah, Payal is there. Payal, you have raised your hand first. Payal, please tell me what's the mistake here.
Sir, our team is a plural and was is a singular. You tell that with plural verb, plural subject, we use plural helping verb. So, correct sentence is our teams were playing well in the tournament.
Very good. You have given the nice explanation. Very good, Payal. Our Thank teams you, were playing well in the tournament. Very good. Good answer. So, let's see the answer. Our teams were playing well in the tournament. Next, what he was writing in those days. What he was writing in those days. What's the mistake in this sentence? Who will let me know? Sanchi, you please tell me. Sanchi Bhatia, please tell me. What's the mistake in this sentence? What he was writing in those days.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
What he was.
You should
sir, I think there is no mistake
There is no mistake. Okay, I tell you the mistake. There is a mistake. Actually, I have told you whenever we make any interrogative sentence, जब हम question करते हैं, so सामने वाले को कैसे पता लगता है कि आप question कर रहे हो? So by the helping verb. You use the helping verb before the subject. Are you getting the mistake?
Yes. What was he writing in those days?
Yes, very good. What was he writing in those days? So helping verb we need to use before the subject whenever we make any interrogative sentence. Very good. Next sentence. It was hide the nuts in a hole. It was hide the nuts in a hole. Who will let me know? Mansi, please tell me. Mansi, you please tell me.
Sir, it was hiding the nuts in a hole.
It was hiding the nuts in a hole. Right, very good. Right answer. Dear students, only 3 minutes are left. 3 or 4 minutes are left. We can't do rest of exercise. So those exercises we will do in our next class. Now, if you want to ask any question regarding today's class, please raise your hand, come forward. Otherwise,